Now, another sad story today. A little three-year-old boy's in the hospital after an accident involving matches and lighter fluid. He has severe burns over half his body now. This happened yesterday on Railroad Street in Millville. That's in Wabasha County. Little boy has since been transported to Regents Hospital in St. Paul, and that is where our Steve Tellier is live tonight with more. Steve?
Leah, at last check, that little boy was still listed in critical condition. He's being treated at the burn unit here at Regents Hospital. Meanwhile, some parents are hoping that this incident will serve as a reminder to other parents of just how dangerous matches can be when they're in the hands of children.
The matches on the railing, the lighter fluid on the steps, the burned up lunchbox on the ground. 24 hours later, little had been disturbed in the spot where a three-year-old boy was severely burned over more than half of his body.
We just heard the ambulance and we didn't know what was going.
The little boy had just stopped by Taylor Hines' house to ask if she could play with him. She couldn't. About 20 minutes later, the three-year-old was playing with his three older brothers, age 9 and under, and their toys of choice were matches and lighter fluid. Sheriff's deputies say the boy filled a tin lunchbox with lighter fluid and lit it on fire, but when one of the boys tried to put out the flames by stomping on the lunchbox, flaming liquid splashed onto his three-year-old brother.
Oh, my heart breaks for him because it's just, you know, this little boy is going to suffer. Just terrible burns are awful.
Deputies say the boy's mother burned her own hands trying to douse the flames on her son. She then soaked her three-year-old in a bathtub until an ambulance arrived. He was rushed to the hospital and was initially listed in critical condition.
My heart just sunk. I have three children of my own, and my heart goes out to them.
On Tuesday, the terrible accident was the talk of the tiny town of Millville.
My prayers are with them and their family, and stay strong and get through this, and hopefully this helps a lot of their families be more aware of what's, you know, kids are getting into. And
keep matches away from them.
And while some parents talk to their little ones about the dangers of matches and lighter fluid, one of those little ones just wants her playmate back.
Please get well.
Now, sheriff's deputies are calling this an accident. They say they do not expect to file any criminal charges in this case because the mother was at home at the time this happened, and also because she, of course, immediately rushed to her little boy's aid when he was on fire. Live at Regents Hospital, I'm Steve Tellier, 5 Eyewitness.